Hello. I do hope this is working because it's been a while since I've done one of these. How are we all doing? Hope you can hear me. Hey, George. Hey, Alex. Hey, Maury. Hey, Callum. Hey, Automan. Do it all myself, GP. Yeah, so I thought it'd be fun to do a Vettel team. Obviously, the bit of the meme at the last race was the fact that he's doing all his own strategy and stuff. But genuinely, I think he'd be... Out of all the people that are in F1 right now, I genuinely think he'd be the best as the kind of person that would want his own team and also would kind of be a really good team principal as well. And yeah, driver-wise, I feel like it's got to be Kimi's son because that would be awesome. And basing off this car, which is the X2019... It's obviously a futuristic car, so Robin Raikkonen wouldn't be in the sport for a while. And yeah, this is the logo that I've kind of made just very quickly as like a Vettel Racing logo. But anyway, let's do it. Gonna have to remember how to do all this because it's been a while. It's absolutely roasting as well today. I don't do good in the heat. And also, this car is the worst car in the world to paint. And also, my glasses are steaming up. Lovely. Also, Frank is here because Katie's out. So you might be able to hear him because he's a naughty little boy who, since lockdown, has had even worse separation anxiety. Because I guess he's just used to us being home all the time. We actually do need aircon in the UK now. I'm in a kind of newish build house as well. And they are not made with hot summers in mind. I guess they were built before that.
I'm going to take my glasses off because they keep steaming up because it's so hot.
That's all right, Matt. It's cool how many... I wish I'd known about it earlier because I was very late to this game, but it's amazing how many people have messaged me and said, like... Oh, I ended up getting Gran Turismo just for the livery editor, which people kind of take the mick out of and stuff, but it's so good. Such a powerful tool. And if you think for kind of livery noobs like me and stuff that just want to have a bit of fun and can't be bothered to sit in Photoshop on a PC game and constantly go back and forth, back and forth, back and forth. So for this car, I know this is quite tedious, but I'm just going to black out this section because it always looks a lot cooler when it's done like that. And I really need to do a tips video. Every stream I'm like, oh yeah, the tips video. I do apologize that I've not got around to it. Obviously, with the season starting, WTF1 is in full swing. And going unbelievably well at the moment, I have to say. Very, very, very pleased with how it's going. We're getting sort of record numbers on everything, which is awesome. What do I think about Gran Turismo 7? I will definitely be getting it at some point. I would really like, obviously, really hoping they do a livery editor, because why wouldn't you want that? So as you can see, I've got, so while I'm doing this, I'll just show you the sponsors. So Pirelli, obviously, and I've just picked a few random sponsors, tried to relate them to Vettel a little bit. So maybe BMW sponsoring them, because Vettel was obviously very closely associated with them. Bosch, German. Shell, he's worked with Shell a lot of his career, and I think he's a, especially at Ferrari, done a lot of work with them. Casio, I read online that he's some kind of, maybe an ambassador, I don't know, or was. So yeah, got some nice graphics, and then obviously I made my own logo and numbers and stuff for this car, because obviously the team doesn't exist, it's just a fantasy team. So so dare I ask what people thought of the Spanish Grand Prix? Do I dare ask? Or maybe not. Snooze fest. Yeah, wasn't great. You'd think I'm crazy, but action-wise, there's been worse races. I think it's just the fact that it really hasn't helped having the whole like threat of rain thing in so many races this year. So, pattern-wise, unsurprisingly, it's going to be like his helmet to a point. Obviously, I won't make it just plain white. I'll try and add a bit more fun to it. But I really like his helmet design. I've said it so many times. And one of the really cool helmets he did is where he made the yellow almost like a brawn yellow. So I'm going to do that a little bit. Yeah, I was tempted to watch the NASCAR, but it's just too hard to watch it. Like, can't find a stream anywhere or anything, so. Because I am interested to kind of watch NASCAR on a road course. I like Indy ovals, but I've never really got into the NASCAR ovals, to be perfectly honest. You're watching the Spanish Grand Prix now, F1 fanatic Jamie. I'm not going to say don't watch it, but it's not amazing. I really like this color yellow. Obviously, Lando uses it on his helmet. And Brawn, that's quite cool. I didn't really mean to do that. But it does look kind of cool, so I might. Okay, it just looks like the Brawn at the moment, but. Kind of wanna it's too thick. Thank you. Oh, thank you, Rob. It's very nice of you. Yeah, I must say I'm enjoying work and life a hell of a lot at the moment. It's kind of been a bit manic the last year or so, but yeah, exciting. Obviously didn't expect to be stuck indoors, that wasn't part of the plan, but all things considered, I mean, we're doing all right. I know it looks a little bit green, the like a greeny yellow, but it's deliberate. I'm going for like a I think Vettel used on his helmet once, like a kind of bright color. So am I making up the livery as I go? Yeah. Obviously, got a slight idea in mind to do something with his helmet and stuff, but it's all pretty much going with the flow. That's quite cool. Trying to find a picture of the Mercedes I did, because it's just a nice I was quite happy with the sponsor placement, and I'm kind of gonna do something similar, because this car is not easy to paint. Our people watching the Indy 500 this week. Oops. don't know about this yet. I'm just messing about. Where do you watch Indy in the UK? It'd be on Sky Sports F1. I'm looking forward to it. My favourite race of the year, but bit of a shame. Obviously there won't be any fans this time. Because it is very much one of those races where all the fans really make a difference there. Got this Shell Energy logo. I feel like that's quite a cool, like, sort of makes it more kind of modern looking. Thoughts on the MotoGP crash? Oh my days. Absolutely terrifying. Both of them. There was the Moto2 one, which was terrifying enough as it was. And then, yeah, really scary. Really, really scary. I mean, Rossi. It's really scary to think if Rossi was a tenth quicker in the first sector, he's literally getting annihilated by that bike, and that's a really, really scary thought. But amazed he carried on. I know they're MotoGP riders and that's what they do, but oh my word. Absolutely terrifying. Because he looked so shaken from the when it kind of cut to him. Right. It's going to be a strange year in MotoGP actually, because Marquez is obviously out. Does anyone know how long Marquez is out for? I've not really had the time to follow it as much this year. Like, is he going to be returning at all? Has he just sacked the year off because he knows it's over? Ah, the joys of sponsors on this game. Oh, not Matty G. Such a Tommy WTF1 fanboy. Can't get enough of my streams. In the black of night, murder. God's sake. There we go. The struggle of this game to also, what's that? Oh, I didn't realize he strained his hand, made it worse. So I guess Marquez, is he out the title? Is that what people are saying? Because how many races are they going to be in MotoGP? I don't know if it's like F1 where they've gone sort of. Like they've kind of making the calendar up as they go along, if you like, with like the RNF1. Portimao, good race for F1. Yes, I do. If I'm honest, I'm amazed that it's never been on the calendar before, although I've heard it's unbelievably bumpy, which would be cool, but they're resurfacing the whole thing, so that won't be a problem. But yeah, I'm really excited for Portimao, however you say it. Just need Da Costa to come out of nowhere and just get an F1 drive for the race. That'd be nice. So what do people think to Turkey? Turkey coming back, that's quite quite exciting. And then what I've heard is that the next triple header is going to be Turkey, Bahrain, the normal Bahrain Grand Prix, and then Bahrain on the outer loop, which I'm so glad that they're going to do that, if that does happen. I'm absolutely buzzing about that, because I love circuits that are a little bit different. And it doesn't get more different than that. So, yeah, exciting. And if you've not seen Bahrain Outer, go check it out. It's going to be a very odd race indeed. And then after Bahrain Outer, it's Abu Dhabi, and then that's it, 17 races by the sound of it. So exciting. It's interesting that we've gone from no F1 at all to an absolutely unbelievable calendar. Downloaded this shape and I was kind of tempted to do something with it. I don't know yet. Turkey's not confirmed yet, no, but from a lot of sources and things that I've heard, it's any day now. Oh yeah, we've not even mentioned the AWS rankings yet. Do I even need to ask what people think of those? If you can say it without swearing. Utter rubbish, to put it politely. So, if you haven't seen this, the reason for Kovalainen and Trulli, it makes sense, but it's absolutely rubbish. Like, when you find out why, like, what they did, it makes sense why they're there. But it doesn't mean it doesn't mean that it's a good thing to do. Because I saw someone basically share Jarno Trulli's qualifying results. So you probably know that it's based on qualifying, which is why Alan Prost is so low. But yeah, it's based on qualifying, which is why Alan Prost is so low, because obviously he famously kind of did his set up the car kind of for the race and not qualifying. So he wasn't particularly a great qualifier, so that's gone against him. But Jarno Trulli famously was an amazing qualifier. And basically, Jarno Trulli out-qualified Alonso, Jenson Button, every single driver he competed against. He competed against a lot. Jarno Trulli out-qualified, apart from one. And that's obviously Fernando Alonso's fifth on the list, which maybe is too high. Some people maybe think that's fair. Amazing driver, no doubt. But he's number five on the list, which isn't outrageously far-fetched, of course. But because Trulli out-qualified him and a load of other drivers like Jenson Button and stuff, his rating goes absolutely skyrocket, which is why he's so high on the list. And then Jarno Trulli's last seasons in F1 were with Lotus, the kind of fake Lotus. And basically, Heikki Kovalainen beat Jarno Trulli in qualifying when Jarno Trulli was very much past his peak and very old by that point. So then obviously Heikki Kovalainen, the algorithm's gone, well, Jarno Trulli is amazing at qualifying, he's really quick. So that's shot him up the list, because they're like, well, he's trounced this Jarno Trulli guy who's amazing at qualifying, so... But the thing is, yeah, Karen, you're right. That where's George Russell? I can only assume they didn't count him because he's only done one season and it would skew the results too much. But Robert Kubica's 20th on the list and George Russell out-qualified him in every single race. So I imagine he would have been ridiculously high up, no? I don't know. What I will say that's maybe a little controversial is that I don't think they'd have done it if Ayrton Senna wasn't top. I And I don't think Formula One realistically should be posting. Stuff like that. I don't know what people think, but Formula One, I don't know, is it a bit weird for Formula One themselves to be like, Lewis Hamilton is the best driver in F1 by a long shot, because then it just gives fuel to people that think that the page is biased or, you know, stuff like that. So I don't know, I personally don't think it's a particularly good idea for a sport itself to be like, this is the best driver. It was always gonna cause people to get upset and annoyed and because I know it's like, it's just an algorithm, but is it fair for them to like, for F1 themselves to say like, disrespect Alain Prost like that? Because he's already, one of those drivers that doesn't get enough credit. And then for F1 themselves to release a list and be like, oh, Alain Prost is 20th behind Lando Norris and Carlos Sainz. You're like, is that a good thing to release? I mean, it's sponsored, so AWS will have paid them a rather bucket ton of money. Gonna save this while I can. Yeah, it's funny that video that we did on driver comparisons, I think went over people's heads a little bit. I don't think people got that it was meant to be a joke. So if you've not seen it, we did a video that was kind of ironically, it's just like the AWS thing where you can prove anyone is better than anyone by just going, well, this person beat this person beat this person, and then Karthikeyan beat Ricciardo when he was at HRT, who beat Sebastian Vettel when he was at Red Bull, who got beaten by Kimi Raikkonen, who got beaten by Alonso, who got beaten by Hamilton or whatever. You know, you can say that anyone is the best driver ever. Does anyone know the Champions League score? Out of Schumacher and Schwartzman, who should get promoted to F1? I mean, boring answer, but whoever. Whoever does better in F2. Well, that's a really obvious thing to say, but the teammates. Like, I feel like Mick has made quite a few mistakes this year. So yeah, I think if either of them have a really good season. I mean, Giovinazzi's not performing in my opinion. Yeah, Mick's made a few mistakes. Tsunoda, on the other hand, I'm really, really impressed by him. I think if he keeps improving, then someone is going to get themselves an AlphaTauri drive. Because I think it's fair to say that Kvyat's seat potentially up for grabs. I don't think they'll get rid of him unless something, you know, really major. Like, I think if Tsunoda has a really good season, then perhaps they'll do it, but I don't know, it's interesting. Yeah, it's going to be an interesting year in F2 to see what happens. And Callum Ilott was doing ridiculously well, but had a bit of a not difficult race, but. What's going on in the chat? Sorry, I'm a bit quiet. I was concentrating.
Yeah, Tsunoda. Tsunoda was awesome in that Austria race. Had the team radio failure, which cost him a lot of points. I've not actually looked at the F2 standings in a while. The last time I checked, it was Callum. Callum was leading by quite a decent margin. Right, I want to add some more. Yeah, I think Schwartzman definitely one of the most impressive young drivers out there at the moment, so I think he's got a very good chance to get promoted. No disrespect to Mick, but I think if Mick got promoted when Schwartzman beat him in the championship, I think there'd be even more pressure on him, because people would say, whether rightly or wrongly, that he's only got the drive because of his dad. And I do wonder how many of his mistakes are the fact that he's just... he must be under so much pressure, it's unbelievable. But I mean... Raikkonen goes. Whether Giovinazzi will stay as well. I personally think that Perez and... like Schwartzman or a young driver would be a really good lineup for Alpha.
Antonio Felix da Costa in F1. Can't see it happening. I think he said himself that he's turned down some offers. Whether that's true or not. But I don't know. For me, he's may sound maybe a bit over the top, but for me, he's the best driver that I've ever seen not to have got an F1 drive. So it's a big shame. He never, you know, ends up in F1, but can't discredit what he's doing in Formula E. It's a really competitive championship now, and it's an interesting point that do you want to be like, what would you rather do? Be at the back in a Formula One race unable to win, unable to score a point sometimes, or have a legitimate shot at a world championship in WC or Formula E? Come on, mate, come up here. Say hello to your fan club. Oh, here's Frankie. Hello. Right. Frankie meets Minton. Yes. Do need to sort that at some point. I don't think Albon's going to be dropped, personally. I don't know, what do you guys think? I think he'll last the season, regardless. But if he doesn't improve, then Red Bull are going to have a very, very, very interesting kind of, yeah, very interesting job on their hands. So, it's very, yeah, I think Gasly's going to be the thing is, I say I don't think he's going to get replaced mid-season or end of the year, but if he doesn't improve, and Gasly carries on the way he's doing right now, which you'd argue that he's one of the best performers so far this season. I don't think that's unfair to say that Gasly's been kind of one of the standout drivers of the year. Along with the obvious kind of Verstappen and Hamilton. But I mean, it goes without saying now, doesn't it? I feel like those two are just another league to everyone else in F1, personally. annoying sometimes for little things like that. Oh, well, that'll have to do. Oh, thank you, Jim. Glad people like these streams. Like I've said before, it's just a fun kind of chilled out stream. Why do I feel like I'm making my name? Right, what else sponsor-wise do we need on this? Don't want to overdo the sponsors because obviously a bit unrealistic, but I feel like race cars, it just works when they've got quite a lot of sponsors on them. I feel like just filling it with sponsors just seems to, I don't know, it just works. Why is that not appearing? Ah, oh, I'm being stupid. That's why it's not appearing. It's on the wrong layer. Yeah, obviously I'm doing this livery as if it was kind of almost like a future F1 thing. But you're right, Freddie, that I could totally see Vettel doing like a kind of GT team. Obviously hell of a lot cheaper than F1, and might be something that he does to kind of see if he fancies it. Although you do wonder if the days of, I say the days of private teams are over, but they're changing the rules soon, and I hope it attracts some new teams, because I don't feel like there's enough teams in F1 at the moment. Oh, thank you for those comments. Let's say I'm just pretty much just making this one up as I go along, but I think with these things it's always just trial and error. People have any more questions, by the way, do you fire away, because it gives me something to talk about on the stream, because sometimes when I'm doing my when I'm fully concentrating, I kind of forget people are watching and I need to speak. Why is WTF1 not bringing out more F1 gaming experiment content? We're doing a bit of gaming here and there. obviously with F1 in kind of full flow now. Things like podcasts and IBR take up a fair whack, and then we have to think about what other things we can do. But it's always difficult to find the right balance with gaming. We obviously used to do our gaming challenges, stuff like that, which we've not done in a while, to be fair. Maybe that's something to look into. Do I think they'll announce Vettel at Racing Point? Yeah, I do. Like I said in my podcast prediction, I think they're going to announce it before Spa. They seem to Spa seems to be one of those tracks now. I guess it's kind of late on in the season. Yeah, I can, like I say in the podcast, I think they're going to announce it. I don't know anything. It's just based on my opinion, but I think I can just see it happening. I don't want to overdo the German flag here. When they're waiting for Sergio to return to make the announcement. Yeah, that's what I heard. I mean, you can argue that he's not been treated particularly well if he gets fired either way, when he's performed very well, but it would be very harsh for them to drop him when he's got COVID. Do we think that little flash of German flag on the rear wing is a bit too much? Or is it nice? Say yay or nay. That's without it. Actually, you know what I'm going to do? I feel like it's too close to the other German flag, so I'm gonna do it here. And I think that should match the I think it's going to be Vettel and Lance next year. Which I massively rate Perez. I think he's unbelievably underrated. But at the same time, I don't think that a Vettel and Lance lineup is as bad as some people think. Frank's just kicking me. Thank you for that, mate. Much appreciated. Can people see Frank? Look what he's doing. There you go, we can have Frank watch while I'm doing the stream as well. Being weird, aren't you? You're being weird. I feel like it just makes it a bit too busy, maybe. Yeah. Right. Nearly done. It's looking rather cool. I have done, well, I've done the Mercedes livery on this car, Will. Problem is, oh my word, it's such a difficult car to paint. It really is tricky. Right, I'm just having a look around to make sure I've not missed anything, but I think we're pretty much done. Stick another sponsor there, because why not? Have we got? To be honest, I think, oh, I know what I need to do. Let's add, give it a bit of realism by adding the stuff on it. Let me know if you want to see anything in particular next. And yeah, hopefully you're all still enjoying these streams, even though lockdown is over. Well, coronavirus is very much still with us. We're working from home. Save that. Hey Tristan, you've joined just as I'm about to finish. ...2012 McLaren on the Red Bull Junior. I've already done two Vodafone McLaren streams, so I feel like something different. I do quite like the idea of future driver team liveries though. This is a long boy stream. This is the one I did for They're normally about an hour. Every time I paint an X2019, it seems to be a couple of hours, because it's just a long boy stream. But I'll save that and we'll stick it in the old escapes thing, take a picture, and then I will be out of here. But it's been nice to do one of these again and chat to you guys. Apply livery. You comfy there, mate. Frank is definitely living his best life right now. I'm slightly worried he's extremely attached to us now. Let's take a picture of this bad boy. Annoyingly, the only problem with not making it in kind of matte paint, I just realised, is it's really hard to photograph. It's too glossy, and you just get shining light all over it. So let me just. Just gonna make it in the matte finish, just so I can take a decent picture of it, because otherwise it just doesn't seem to like it. Thank you. Just going to change this up. Fact. So it's easier to sort. Oh, I've missed a bit off the front, but it shouldn't matter too much. Better. Nearly done. Thanks everyone who's stuck with this for an hour and 50. What's going on in the football? Oh, shock. Right. Picture time. Yeah, 3-0 to PSG. Love an underdog story. Sigh. Never in a million years would I have thought about supporting Bayern Munich in the Champions League, but... Well, I say that, Leon. But it's not going to happen, is it? But if it's between PSG and Bayern, definitely want Bayern to win. Right, let's try this again. I feel like this escape looks very McLaren Technology Center. There we go. Oh, that looks cool. I like it. Don't know if that's the best scape for it. Let me try this one. There we go. You can see the car a bit more in that one. There we go then. That's the finished car. Kind of based off Vettel's helmet, but using that lighter colour, and then it's got that sort of little bit of texture to the white as well, and the logo. Yeah. Hope you like it. I'll upload this for anyone that actually plays Gran Turismo and wants to use it, although not the most popular car I appreciate to actually race on this game. But there we go. Nearly 2 hours. Thank you for watching. Make a Raghunathan helmet. I'm good. But that's it then. To those of you who have survived this long stream, thank you very much for watching, and speak to you soon. Bye, everybody. You gonna say goodbye? Oh, goodbye, goodbye, goodbye.